And when you look at it, you'll see that most of the items do have some sort of political reference on it, such as the Democrats, the Republicans, the wall, and even the Stormy. The owner says this is a way to spark conversation about what's happening in our country right now. Others believe this normalizes the president's rhetoric.
Lock her up. The immigrant. The wall. Fake news.
I thought it was funny.
I think he's purposely trying to court controversy.
All names of menu items you'll find at the newly opened Urban Taqueria in downtown Albuquerque.
To me, it's not offensive. I just think it's pretty interesting that they decided to be so bold with the names.
All the items on the menu have some sort of political reference.
I think it's kind of neat because you look at it and say, okay, which one am I in favor of today? The Congress or the immigrant or whatever?
The owner of the restaurant, who's an immigrant, says while the menu is edgy,
99% of the people who walk in, I would say more than 99%, don't seem to have an issue with it.
It sparks conversation during a polarized time in our country.
The menu is not designed to insult people or hurt people, but it's just meant to keep the conversation going as to what's happening around us.
But others think the menu is offensive.
The way things are right now, it's not good. We need to have respect for others and have limits.
UNM professor Patricia Perrea says using menu names like the immigrant can be dangerous.
Is that it's normalizing the terms and potentially turning them into like funny or humorous terms.
Considering the different attacks we're seeing in the U.S. and even the deaths at the border, Perrea says terminology like this makes issues we're facing as a country seem okay.
And the more that you do that, the more likely people are to actually repeat them and perhaps forget the context in which they were said, which was usually a context of hate speech.
Now, the restaurant has been open for about 6 weeks. The owner says that most of his staff are immigrants. Marissa Armas, KOAT Action 7 News.